श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। श्री सत्य संध सिंधुतः श्री सत्य वरचंद्रमाः प्रार्थितार्थ प्रदो नित्यं भूयस्यादिष्ट सिद्धये विद्यापीठ विधातारं विद्यावारिधि चंदिरं विद्यार्थिवत्सलं वंदे महामहिम सद्गुरु। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। सत्य धर्म तीर्थरु एन एमिनेंट स्कॉलर एंड पॉन्टिफ ऑफ माध्वा पीठा कोटेड इन वन ऑफ हिज ट्रीटिसेस, द एंटायर क्रेडिट इज नॉट माइन, रादर इट गोज टू माई गुरु श्री सत्यवर तीर्थरु, हूज अबंडेंट ब्लेसिंग्स हैज मेड मी राइट द टिप्पणीज, लाइक हाउ अ फादर वुड मेक हिज सन राइट। दिस शोज द गुरु भक्ति एंड हम्बलनेस ऑफ सत्य धर्म तीर्थरु एंड प्राइमरिली इट डिस्प्लेस द ग्रेटनेस ऑफ सत्यवर तीर्थरु, whose anugraha itself is heartful. Blessings of a guru in any work we endure is very much important. It is a vital essentiality. Satyavara Tirtharu, name itself indicates that he fulfills everyone's wishes. Vara meaning boon. One with pure heart, if wishes something, then it will surely be granted. Satyavara Tirtharu is the shishya of Satyasandha Tirtharu. He is the 26th successor who adorned the great Uttaradhimat Parampara. Though his period of asceticism was only for 3 little years, his remark in the field of Vedanta Samrajya is everlasting. His tapas shakti and siddhi is incomparable. He stood on the principal trio, jnana, bhakti, vairagya, throughout his life and propounded Dvaita philosophy propagated by Srimad Ananda Tirtharu. His Purvashrama name was Haveri Krishnacharya. Also known as Jhulpi Krishnacharya, he was born to Subbannacharya and Bharati Bai. His elder brother Haveri Ramacharya was also a pontiff of Uttaradhimat, Sri Satyasandha Tirtharu, Ashrama Guru of Sri Satyavara Tirtharu. Imagine how blessed the couple might be. They gave birth to 2 gems. Both of them became the pontiffs of Uttaradhimat. This is the fruit of their punya. Krishnacharya completed his initial education near his father. For advanced studies, he went to Tirupati and learnt it from Balacharya, who was an eminent scholar in Vyakarana and Mimamsa. For Sudha Adhyayana, Krishnacharya and Ramacharya approached Satyabodha Tirtharu, the pontiff of that time. Satyabodha Tirtharu nurtured many pearls of Dvaita Siddhanta. Along with Ramacharya and Krishnacharya, Gurrajacharya was also one of the disciples. All three of them became the pontiffs of Madhva Siddhanta, Satyasandha Tirtharu, Satyavara Tirtharu and Satyaparayan Tirtharu respectively. Satyabodha Tirtharu gave ashrama to Satyasandha Tirtharu. Later, Satyasandha Tirtharu handed over the throne to Jhulpi Krishnacharya and named him Satyavara Tirtharu. We all are familiar with the saying, Yatha Raja Tatha Prajaha. The meaning of this saying is, as the king, so the subjects. Satyavara Tirtharu followed the path shown by his guru. He also nurtured 2 great pearls of Dvaita Siddhanta, Sri Vishnu Tirtharu and Sri Satyadharma Tirtharu, his successor. The context of Vishnu Tirtharu is quite interesting. Vishnu Tirtharu, Jaitirthacharya in his Purvashrama, was once sitting on a cot in the veranda of his house. A saint was passing by chanting the kirtan of Sri Purandara Dasaru. The lines were, Mancha baradu madadi baradu, kanchu kannadi baradu, sanchitartha dravya baradu, munche madiro dharmavu. Jaitirtha immediately renounced samsara life and approached Satyavara Tirtharu and asked him to ordain him into Sannyasa Ashrama. Satyavara Tirtharu did the same and named him as Vishnu Tirtharu. Satyavara Tirtha Swamiji performed 24 lakh Pranav Mantra Japa for the well-being of Brahmins and Brahmin community. He did Anna Santarpane to 1 lakh Brahmins. That is what we call Laksha Brahmana Bhojana. That event looked like Nabhuto Nabhavishyati. Neither in the past nor in the future, this kind of holy activity could ever happen. He performed Koti Tulsi Archane to Lord Sri Rama and Sita Devi. Satyavara Tirtharu, as usual, on his travel, visited Tirupati and took the darshan of Lord Sri Venkateshwara and left to Penagonda, Sri Vedavyas Tirtharu. Divan Pandit Purnayacharya requested His Holiness to move to Namagondlu, citing the unfavorable political climate of that time. Swamiji accepted so and stayed back at Namagondlu. After few days, on Ashada Shuddha Chaturdashi, as usual, Satyavrata Tirtharu was becoming ready for daily morning rituals. A thief sneaked into Swamiji's room and stole Ramadevara Pettige, which had idols of Lord Sri Rama and Sita Devi along with few jewels. Everyone searched a lot, and after futile efforts, Swamiji thought that Lord Rama has been testing him for some reason. Immediately he took an oath. He vowed to fast until the idols are found. Purnayacharya, learning this, persuaded a lot. He requested Holiness to give up fasting and promised to put entire resources and full efforts to find the idols. But Satyavrata Tirtharu stood stern on his decision. He performed daily puja, took Tirtha and went into deep meditation. This continued for 20 long days. Perhaps finally God has shown mercy on him. On 21st day, Navaratna Annayacharya, a pioneer of Satyavara Tirtha Swamiji, as usual to perform his daily routine, he went near the well. To his surprise, he found the idols on a plantain leaf near the well. Navaratna Acharya's joy knew no bounds. He handed them to Holiness Satyavara Tirtharu. Satyavara Tirtharu sanctified the idols according to the Shastras and performed puja. That day, he conducted a grand commemoration. Gradually, the health condition of Swamiji deteriorated and sensed his end to be near. So, he decided to give Pita to Navaratna Annacharya because he was the one who discovered the idols. Perhaps Lord Sri Rama also wanted the same. On Shravana Shukla Panchami, Sri Satyavara Tirtharu gave the ascetic throne to Sri Navaratna Annayacharya and named his successor as Sri Satyadharma Tirtharu. Exactly after 2 days, on Shravana Shuddha Saptami, Satyavara Tirtharu left his mortal body in Namagondalu and his Brindavani is constructed at Sante Bidunur. Satyavara Tirtharu dedicated his entire life to Dvaita philosophy. He carried forward the torch of Vedanta Samrajya. He was a noble scholar, expert and an ardent devotee of Lord Sri Rama. Even today, whoever visits Sante Bidnuru, they don't return back empty-handed. Today on his Aradhana, let us all do good deeds in life and follow the path led by Guru Madhvacharya. Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.